How does the underwater train transit work? How do trains go through under the sea? How do the passengers breathe so deep down there? What if there is a technical failure? Do the passengers get trapped underwater until the issue is fixed? What if there is a fire or a water leakage? What are the contingency plans for that? In this video, we'll get answers to all these questions with an understanding of how the underwater trains work. So without any further ado, let's get started. Underwater trains move to and fro from point A to point B under the water, be it a sea or a river, via solid concrete underwater tunnels. These tunnels are dug in the seabed via massive tunnel boring machines, also known as TBMs. They are pretty powerful to dig tunnels in a very short span of time. So, before any of the actual construction begins, the topology of the place, ground conditions, geology, water pressure, environmental impact, ease of excavation, etc. are studied to ensure that everything looks good to set up a transit infrastructure at the place. The ground should be strong enough to hold the load of the tunnel and the fast-moving trains. When everything looks okay, the engineers are satisfied, the digging begins. Though it's not a rule of thumb, but there are generally three tunnels put together, two train tunnels for trains moving in opposite directions and a service tunnel which connects them. The service tunnels is dig first, it is the pilot tunnel and helps determine the conditions of the place. The rail tunnels are linked to each other via a service tunnel and there are passes built every 200 to 400 meters between them. There is a piston relief duct between the two train tunnels to manage the air pressure between them caused by the fast moving trains. The service tunnel provides fresh air ventilation and is used for the emergency evacuation. It has emergency and maintenance service vehicles that allow fast access to all the areas of the tunnel. Air is supplied in from the surface. It also has a supplementary ventilation on the sides. The tunnels have a mechanical cooling system with refrigeration plants on both sides that run chilled water throughout the tunnel to regulate the temperature. Each wagon of the train has a fire detection and extinguishing system. Fire sensors are present throughout the tunnel. The ventilation system can control the smoke movement in case of a fire. It maintains a high pressure in the service tunnel so that in the event of a fire, the smoke does not enter it from the rail tunnels. Service tunnel transportation system vehicles are on firefighting duty at all times. Water pumping systems are deployed which remove water from the tunnels in case of any seepage or leak. The trains are powered by the overhead power line. They have dedicated substations for it. The walkways on both sides of the tunnel are built for ease of evacuation and to assist the train stay upright in case of derailment. Speaking of the communication, the personnel deployed in the service tunnel are in contact with each other via radio communication. There is also a TTR, track to train radio system for communication between trains and the railway control center on the surface. There is also an internal radio system in the wagons for communication between the service crew and the passengers. So this is how the entire underwater transit infrastructure is carefully thought and set up, making a journey through it super safe. Well guys, this is pretty much it. If you liked the episode, do hit that like button, share it with your folks, hit the bell icon to stay notified of the new content on the channel. I'll see you in the next episode. Until then, cheers.